all its influence on modern pop culture, the original Star Trek series wasn't that popular. It only made it to 3 seasons before being cancelled in 1969. But it was popular enough that the cast and crew took some of the ideas they had for future episodes and made a shorter, much lower budget animated series in 1973, which at the time was confusingly also just called Star Trek. It only got the subtitle The Animated Series later on. The animated series is okay. It was never quite able to find its audience. It was much too dry and serious to be a kid's show, yet too short and, well, animated to appeal to adults. It received critical praise, but never really took off and ended after only 1.5 seasons itself. Despite being a massive Star Trek fan, I had never watched it myself, so I picked a couple episodes and they were better than I was expecting. The show really is just Star Trek again, but shorter and looking like an animated series from the 1970s. The technical limitations of the time and the budget really distract from the genuinely good storytelling being done in the series. This episode from season 2 is primarily known for this image, but the episode is actually about a plague that occurred 19 years ago, which this alien civilization believes Dr. McCoy caused, and they wish to try and execute him as a mass murderer. Kirk and Spock go to investigate the plague, but end up catching it too, so Spock has to break McCoy out of prison so they can find a cure.
Captain, you're blue.
The primary symptom of this virus is that you turn into different colours and pass out a lot. It's a little bit goofy, but that's the charm of the series, and of the original Star Trek as well. It's easy enough to see why this show never found its audience, and even today I think there's a small amount of people who could genuinely enjoy a show this old, stilted, and just plain weird. But there's certainly more to be found in it than just a couple of memeable screenshots. So anyway, 50 years later, in honour of this short-lived animated series, CBS produced some of the worst comedy shorts I've ever seen in my entire life.
Did you, just pick your nose with a hand?
Of course! Picking our nose is a sign of respect among our people!
We believe boogers represent our essence and bind us to all things.
Where to begin? Well, okay, Short Treks was a series of short films released between seasons of Star Trek Discovery. They ranged massively in quality, some of them are pretty good, some of them are practically unwatchable, but for the most part they existed as a marketing tool to make sure that you stayed subscribed to CBS All Access. Very Short Treks is a series of 5 animated short skits animated in the 70s style starring returning actors from all eras of Star Trek. They were released over the past month to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the animated series and to celebrate, I guess, Star Trek animation in general. And they're really, really bad to the point of practically inducing physical pain. There are a few things in this world worse than bad comedy. It's uncomfortable to watch and frustratingly difficult to explain because humour is so inherently subjective. But if unfunny jokes were the only problem, then we wouldn't be here. There are things more fundamentally wrong with these shorts than unfunny comedy. Really basic fundamental questions. Why do these exist? Who are they for? What do they say as art? I don't know is the answer to these questions, but I certainly have my theories. And they're not very good. So let's just go through these one by one, shall we? The first very short trek is called Skin a Cat, and it's about how you can't see anything in this liberal woke world without offending someone these days.
Ensign, please, don't get your knickers in a twist!
How dare you!
What?
We Nickersonians are a proud species who serve the Federation with honor!
I wish I was kidding, but that's it. That's the joke. Whatever metaphor the captain uses conjures someone to be offended by it. And we, as the audience, are supposed to laugh at the silly-looking alien who is literally a talking bum. I have many concerns about this, but let's start with the basic one. Besides the art style, in what way does this joke and this comedy short honour the memory of the animated series? Because it's the first on-screen appearance of Lieutenant Moress in 50 years? I'm glad she got to come back to be part of this conservative dad joke. The animated series is not a comedy. It's produced a few memes because of its weird stilted animation, but it's not intentionally funny. And if you watch it, it's really unintentionally funny either. A comedy skit in honour of it only makes sense if you view the animated series through the modern lens of funny old cartoon instead of what the show actually was, Star Trek the Animated. Animating these shorts in the old style isn't being done out of any kind of admiration. The art style is a joke. Isn't this old animation so funny and bad? It's making fun of the animated series. That's a joke that can barely sustain a static image, let alone 5 4-minute comedy skits. The joke itself is so clearly of the modern era that it doesn't fit with the style at all, so even if the short looks like it could have aired in the 70s, the actual humour of the piece clearly couldn't. And the humour... oh boy. It's just the one joke again. You know the one. I identify as an attack helicopter, it's just that. Actually, I identify as a pair of knickers, and this is really offensive to my culture. It's that same deliberate exaggeration designed to make fun of how there are so many genders and races and pronouns these days. It's wokeness gone mad, I tell you. The joke would barely be funny once. Being dragged out over 3 minutes is just painful. But more important to me is how antithetical the joke is to the core concepts of Star Trek. Infinite diversity and infinite combinations. So, in the original series, the crew of the Enterprise meet Abraham Lincoln. It's not really Abraham Lincoln, it's a recreation of Abraham Lincoln by a species of rock aliens who create the biggest heroes and villains of history and make them fight each other. But whatever, they meet Abraham Lincoln, he's on the bridge of the Enterprise, and he meets Lieutenant Uhura, and he drops a racial slur.
Excuse me, Captain Kirk.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Scott.
What a charming negress.
Being Abraham Lincoln, he quickly apologizes, realizing that that term might be considered offensive in the future. But Uhura isn't offended. She's confused.
Oh, forgive me, my dear. I know that in my time, some use that term as a description of property.
But why should I object to that term, sir? You see, in our century, we've learned not to fear words.
This moment isn't really relevant to the episode, but it's interesting that they included it anyway because of what it says about the future presented in Star Trek. Not only does racism not exist, it so doesn't exist that the worst racial slurs of our time aren't even considered offensive anymore. They're just words now, they don't hold any of the meaning that they used to. It's what makes Star Trek unique as a sci-fi property. Sci-fi can often be a very cynical genre. They present us with worlds where the problems of today are just carried on into the future in new forms, and that can be a good way to talk about those issues. Star Trek does that too, sometimes, but for the most part it leans on optimism instead. The problems of today will be gone by then. We will have resolved and moved past them. The future of humanity is a bright one. The joke of skin a cat is just a complete contradiction of this entire concept. Not only are people offended by these turns of phrase, we're supposed to laugh at how ridiculous they look. We're supposed to participate in the racism. Ha ha, that man's a screw, lol. It's so opposite to everything that Star Trek is, which makes it feel very strange as a bit of Star Trek marketing, doesn't it? Who is this supposed to appeal to? Fans of the original animated series will be put off by how modern it is. Fans of New Trek will be put off by how borderline offensive it is. This isn't going to attract anyone to watch Star Trek because even if it somehow does convince someone to try watching, they're quickly going to learn that Star Trek isn't actually anything like this. It's a baffling thing to exist. And this is only the first one. The second one is at least slightly better. It's called Holiday Party, and the joke of this one is that Spock doesn't understand comedy, and so shows everyone a blooper reel of tragic death and violence.
The interference is preventing me from beaming him up. Sir, it's too risky.
We have to beam him up now, so do it.
Blooper.
I mean, it's still not great, but I'm not made of stone. This one at least got a couple of light chuckles out of me. But still, like the last short, there's nothing about this that feels particularly Star Trek-y. The joke is based on a very old, outdated idea of what comedy is, that being that all comedy is inherently based on misery. See, the conclusion of this isn't that Spock is wrong per se, he's just taking it too far. The correct blooper, and the one that we're supposed to agree is a good blooper that the people laugh at, is an ensign getting hit in the balls with a mop and then shitting his pants full of diarrhea. It's very mean-spirited and, well, illogical. There's not really a fundamental difference between this ensign losing his legs and this ensign shitting his pants. It's just the severity of the incident that's different. Both are based on laughing at someone else's misfortune, like, the audience within the short doesn't laugh. But we, the real audience, are supposed to laugh at the ship blowing up, right? The explosion keeps happening in a comedic sort of way. We we need to talk about Lower Decks, because I'm worried that I'm making it sound like humor in Star Trek is a bad idea, but I couldn't disagree with that more. Star Trek is prime for a comedy series. It's just not this kind of comedy. I have my issues with Lower Decks. There's only so many times you can make an obscure Deep Space Nine reference before the joke starts to wear thin. But the best jokes in Lower Decks are when they use the optimism and positivity of Star Trek as part of the joke. For example, there's an excellent gag in the early seasons of Lower Decks where Rutherford is constantly switching between departments, and the expected outcome, where everyone is sad and upset and angry at him for leaving, is subverted. Instead, everyone is really happy and supportive of him.
Are you saying what I think you're saying, Ensign?
I'd like to request a transfer out of engineering.
Consider your request granted! Oh man, this is exciting! I'm sure wherever you end up, they'll be lucky to have you.
Aw, thanks guys! I'm gonna miss you!
That's a joke that's not based on laughing at someone else's pain. Maybe it's not laugh out loud funny, but it makes you smile in a really sincere way. Lower Decks is full of little moments like that, moments where they subvert the expected outcomes because things don't work like that in Star Trek. And I may get tired of the references sometimes, but after 60 years, there's a goldmine of dumb nonsense in Star Trek for joke fodder, so I can see why they do it at least. These very short treks don't use Star Trek as a platform to tell jokes about Star Trek. They use it as a platform to tell dumb, boring jokes that you've heard 100 times before. A guy gets hit in the balls and shits his pants. Roll the laugh track, I guess. I'm not trying to insult you if you find this kind of humor funny. It's just very simple, it's slapstick, it's not very clever. But let me tell you, that diarrhea has got nothing on the unrepentant levels of shade that is the third very short trek. If you're eating right now, maybe take a break. The third short, Worst Contact, is pure unrepentant garbage. Sorry, let me try that again. Worst Contact is about a first contact mission with Riker and Dr. Crusher, where the culture of this alien species is so gross that they destroy their warp drive to make sure they can never come to space.
We must celebrate with our national dish!
Leftover fish cooked in microwaves! We look forward to coming aboard your ship to microwave fish in your break rooms for all your crew! Oh no! You forgot to add the sauce!
Oh no. Look! Gorn invaders!
What?
This short is just gross. I mean, yes, in that way, but in bigger ways than that too. This is a short where our heroes deny the rights of another species and, point of fact, destroy their technology to make sure that they can't join Galactic Society because they don't like their customs. It explicitly goes against everything that Starfleet stands for within Star Trek and everything that Star Trek stands for in general. I mean, it's literally a violation of the Prime Directive. We live in a post-COVID world. I understand that. I too would be hesitant to shake this man's hand. But let's put hygiene aside for a second and imagine that instead of just being gross, this was about how they didn't like their cultural practice of nose piercings or tattoos. Or maybe they just don't like the smell of their food even if it isn't microwave fish. The short is inviting us to judge another people's culture as wrong, which is a complete contradiction of infinite diversity and infinite combinations. We can have infinite diversity as long as I like what your diversity brings to the table. If I don't, then you can just get stuffed. There are certainly some unethical practices that are worth condemning, fundamental rights violations like slavery, for example. And walking that line is something that many Star Trek episodes have explored. Is it possible to respect another culture when that culture participates in practices that you consider to be fundamentally evil?
It's true. You work with your females, arm them, and force them to wear clothing.
But we're not even on that level with these cauliflower men. They're just a bit gross and weird. Who's to say it's even a hygiene issue? Maybe the snot of this species is actually really healthy and safe to touch. In fact, it must be since they cover every surface in it and also eat it. The cauliflower men are not an evil empire, they just have cultural practices that are different to ours, and for that reason, we're supposed to laugh at them and decide they're not worthy to be our equals. That's what's truly gross about this short. They've made it very clear that these very short treks aren't canon, they're just short little vignettes, so on that level I don't really care about all the lore issues that these things get wrong. Like, everything about this first contact scenario is wrong. Species don't get to join the Federation as soon as they get warp drive. Riker should already know about all of their customs because they send scouts ahead of time to make sure that this stuff never happens. Also, Crusher calls Riker Bill for some reason, but, like, who cares? They're 5-minute short skits. The problem is that this isn't a Star Trek joke. He doesn't use Star Trek as a framework to tell jokes. The fact that it is Star Trek and that Jonathan Frakes is here and Gates McFadden is here is just set dressing. Gross out humor was never going to work for me, but there is a Star Trek version of this joke that works, especially when you've got Riker here, the man who happily eats live worms. There's actually, believe it or not, multiple occasions where Riker has eaten live bugs, because Riker is Starfleet to the core. Klingon gack might look gross to us, but will Riker respect other cultures, and he's fundamentally curious to try new things, so he digs right in. That's the version of the short that actually works, if instead of being grossed out, Riker is way too into this culture. When the cauliflower man picks his nose as a sign of respect, Riker would be right in there too, and you can have Crusher concerned about the hygienic implications of all this. Have Riker start flirting with the lady if she's got snot dripping from her nose. Make it that the joke isn't that the culture is gross, but that Riker doesn't give a single shit about how gross they are. That wouldn't make the short good. It's just a conceptually bad idea from the ground up, but it would at least change it from being genuinely offensive to just being kind of tasteless. The final two shorts have mercifully less to talk about. They're mostly rooted in self-referential humor, which is probably what they should have always been instead of these bizarre, borderline offensive skits that have nothing to do with anything. I still don't think either of them have particularly much love for the original animated series, aside from the fact that George Takei reprises his role as Sulu, but they're fine. But 2 out of 5 is a failing grade. And these very short tracks don't just fail, they really, really fail. They're actively detrimental to their entire purpose, which is to promote Star Trek. I actually have no smooth way to end this video. I don't have any grand point that I'm trying to make. It's just like, holy shit, these were bad. Thank you very much for watching, and a very special thank you to my patrons for your continued support. If you'd like to see your name up here or get access to Patreon-exclusive videos, then please consider signing up, it would mean a lot to me. I have plenty more Star Trek videos. If you want a whingy one, then click up here, and if you want a positive one, then click down here. There's more whingy ones than positive ones, but I am a Star Trek fan, I swear.